John's going to lead us in worship while the baptism is going on. Those who are being baptized are going to come forward. I've had a couple come forward who are jumping in with us. I've got a couple of dads that are going to be baptizing their sons with me before Eric gets in for the rest. And so I'm going to have Tim, why don't you and your son come on up? And who else? I'm drawing a blank. Yep. Sean, right? Excellent. And there's one more. Where's my other dad? Kevin.
Yes.
Excellent. Okay, so you three are going to, it's going to be you guys first. And we'll go from there. Let's pray. Father, thank you for today, for this opportunity to celebrate what you have done, to celebrate the saving of lives, the eternity secured by your death in our place, your mercy embraced, and new life poured out. God, thank you. Thank you for today and for this time. We pray it all in Jesus' name. Amen. We only have a limited number of chairs. Most of you look to be of the demographic that's an appropriate choice. Some of you who are younger and wiggly may want to evacuate your chair to provide room for those who maybe aren't feeling quite so energetic in the next 20 minutes. So, and if there's open chairs, feel free to sit down. I don't care how old you are. Shine, you want to start us off?
Good morning.
kick him. I don't know about baptizing someone with a 49ers on. Something very wrong there.
Way to go, Tim.
That's going to become a Seahawks jersey when he comes out.
Forgive them, Father, but they don't have
Amen.
Thank you.
You can get a front row seat.
Thank you.
Cody. There you are. Is it nice?
It's only bad when you get out.
Come on. 49ers t-shirt. The fact that it was really what the church is called to do is to make disciples. And baptism is just one part of that. The other part of that is teaching those who are disciples everything that Jesus has taught us. I want to take a minute. I want to pray for these dads who got in the tub. Yeah. They're going home wet. But way more than that, they are going home with a task. Teaching these ones that they have baptized. Everything that they know about Jesus. Because dads, that's your job, right? Way to go. Getting in here, being a part of this moment in your kids' walk. We need to not just be baptized and eventually dry off. Eventually you will dry off. But we need to stay wet in the sense of staying close to the Lord and continuing to draw close to Him. Don't let this just be a moment, a flash, an emotional thing. But let it be the next step on the journey of growing closer to the Lord, drawing closer to Him and learning more of Him. Let's pray. Father, I thank you for these folks who have come and they, out of obedience to you, out of thankfulness for all that you have done, that they have submitted themselves to baptism. They have been buried at the end of their own life and been raised in new life in Christ. We pray that that would be so evident in them going forward, Lord, that you would just pour out your Spirit upon them, and Lord, that you would do amazing things in and through them. You would use them and work in them and draw them to yourself. Lord, I pray that all who cross their paths would know this is something different. This is someone who has the Spirit of the living God within them. And God, we pray for these dads. Equip them, embolden them, give them endurance, and Lord, use them in their children's lives. We thank you for them. We pray it all in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you guys.